What's going on, guys? It's Greg Mieskestais here today with Lacrosse.com to break down everything you need to know about the new CEO2. So the CEO, as you guys probably already know, quickly became one of the most popular face-off heads on the market after being launched as an attack midfield head. And this is mainly due to some of the best college players in the world using for face-offs because it had some very unique flex points. So after some time, they went back and are re-releasing the CEO2 with some improvements that really optimize it as a face-off specific head. So one thing I really like about this head is they kept the strut pattern and the flex points pretty much exactly the same. If you line this up with a CEO, the struts and the rail thicknesses are all identical, so you can get that same face flex that CEO users have come to know and love. And I think that was really smart by them. Sometimes companies in a 2.0 can overcomplicate things. They kept it really simple and they knew it was working and kept it the same exact way. Some other improvements you face-off guys are going to be happy to see are a shorter throat and a throat plug. This is a pretty simple concept that face-off guys consider a must-have in face-off heads. Get your hand closer to the plastic, more speed, more control, no downsides there for a face-off guy. They also optimize the scoop. The scoop on the CEO is more for attack midfield, it's very pointed. The CEO2, they have a slightly more round option. Nice here, round on the back. Obviously, ground balls are super important for a face-off guy. Here we've got it strung with the Lacrosse.com Pro Strung option. You can upgrade when you buy for just $15. We got the Hero 2.0 semi-soft, some nice knotted SIs, let the ball grab right there in the back, but also release very cleanly like you need to with the new rules. So thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to check out Lacrosse.com where players get their gear for your all new CEO2.